Hi, I'm Dimitri, and in this video we'll see how reports in Clockify work and how you can use them to manage your time tracking data for your team. The detailed report lets you correct entries by clicking on what you wish to edit, just like in the time tracker. To edit multiple entries at once, you can select multiple or all entries that you want to see, and then choose in bulk edit mode what you want to change. Besides a detailed overview of tracked time, the detailed report also lets you add time for others and perform time entry audits. When you want to add time for others, click on the button here and a time entry field will appear. Now enter all the details needed for the entry and select the user or multiple users whose name you want to add time to. When everything is set, click Add and the new entry will appear below. You can also add break time for others. Click on Add Time for Others, add the entry details, and after we've created it, click on these three dots. These give you a number of options for what happens to the entry. So let's mark this entry as a break. Another way is to click on the three dots next to the break entry and click Duplicate. It's important to know that this option will also copy the status of the original time entry. So afterwards, you can change details like the status, who made the entry, and the duration. Now you can filter through your reports by breaks by clicking on the status here. To make sure all entries are recorded accurately, click on the Time Audit button, and then choose what entries you want to filter out. Those of suspicious duration, entries without a project, or entries without tasks. If you chose to see entries with suspicious duration, you can then choose whether those entries are shorter or longer than a number of seconds, minutes, or hours. The rounding feature is useful if you want to export reports with clean-looking numbers. From here, you can change the rounding settings to round up, down, or to the nearest value. Rounding doesn't make any permanent changes to data, so you can turn it off and get the real values back at any time. You can use filters to display only the information you want to export, and once the report displays exactly what you need, you can download it as a nicely formatted PDF or as raw Excel or CSV data. You can also check which entries were invoiced through filtering by invoice status. Plus, you can manually mark entries as invoiced so that they don't get pulled into new invoices or uninvoiced if there was a mistake. For further customization, choose the Customize option and select or deselect the data that you want to include or exclude. For example, if you want to see when a time entry has been created, you can check Creation Date in customizable settings before exporting the report. Or if you want to see how an entry was created, you can simply glance over the start and end times of the entry, where you'll notice that round entries usually have been added manually. You can find more specific details on entry creation or changes on the entry that can be seen through the Audit Log feature. Go to the Workspace Settings, click on the Audit Log tab, and there you'll see the option to display entries that have been created with a timer or manually on a certain date by a certain user. Or you can use this feature to display additional changes made to an entry. If you're up for an even more detailed report, you can use custom fields. For example, if you need to track project IDs, numbers of units, mileage, or anything else like that, you can create a custom field for that. To do that, you go to the Workspace Settings and go to the Custom Fields tab. Click Create and you'll see multiple options for the custom field type. Let's create a custom field for project ID and choose the type number. Let's add this placeholder here and then click Create. Then you can drag it to the visible column and you'll be able to add the ID to each time entry, either through the time tracker or via the timesheet. You can also hide custom fields so users can't see them. Afterwards, if you want to assign project-specific custom fields, you go to the project and go to its settings, and then make it visible. Then each time a user selects this project, the ID will be auto-populated. Once you have custom fields on entries, the custom fields will be visible in the detailed report as well. In the weekly report, you can see users without any recorded time. Now you can quickly add time for them in the detailed report, or you can set reminders to make sure everyone remembers to log their work hours. Let's head over to the team page and then choose the Reminders tab. Here you can set custom reminders for specific people or teams. Click on the blue parts here to customize your reminder. First, select the option to apply this reminder to everyone, including new users, all current members, a group of people, or specific users. Then choose if this reminder will be triggered by less or more than a certain number of hours per day, week, or month. And finally, choose who will receive the reminder. Those members you selected, their managers, or all admins. For example, this means that if all members track less than 40 hours a week, they and their managers will receive a reminder in order to correct time on their timesheets. Timesheets can be logged to prevent additional changes, so reminders work as an additional layer of security to make sure all time logs stay accurate and complete. To log time, head over to the Workspace Settings and then choose the Permissions tab. enable the lock time before switcher and choose the date if you want all entries before that date to be locked. If you want to automatically lock time entries for a specific time period, switch automatically update lock date to on. Select lock frequency to be weekly, monthly, or older than X days, weeks, or months. When selecting the weekly option, you have to select 2 days, when the lock date gets updated, for example Wednesday, and the first day of the week in your company. Let's take Monday for example. This way, when a new week starts on Monday, your team can still add their missing hours for the previous week before that week gets locked, which happens on Wednesday. For the monthly option, you should only choose the day of the month and the time of day on which entries are going to be locked. And when you set an auto-update lock date older than 1 day, it means at the end of the day, the lock date will be automatically updated, so users can't edit yesterday's hours. By default, reports consider Monday to be the first day of the week, but you can change it in your workspace settings and choose Sunday, for example. Afterwards, all of your reports, as well as timesheets, will go from Sunday to Saturday. You can also customize how the date is displayed in profile preferences and indicate whether you wish to use the 24-hour format or 12-hour AM/PM format. And in workspace settings, you can control the duration format and choose whether you wish to see seconds or not. If you turn the seconds off, know that all of your entries will be rounded up to the next minute. Workspace settings also allow you to control time rounding. Here you can set rounding options and specify if you wish to round up, down, or to the nearest 15 minutes or some other interval. Then when you open a report, you can turn on rounding, and all individual entries will be rounded accordingly. The detailed report also helps you control the billability of time entries. This blue currency sign indicates the entry is billable, and the gray sign indicates the entry is non-billable, meaning its rate is zero. The entries initially inherit the billable status from a project. So for example, you can see in this project settings that it's marked as billable. And when you select the project in the time tracker, the entry will also be marked as billable. In the workspace settings, you can choose whether all new projects are billable by default. You can further specify which tasks on a project are billable and which are non-billable, as long as you have task rates enabled in the workspace settings. You can always override these settings in the detailed report. Just click on the currency sign to mark it as billable, or uncheck it to mark it as non-billable. You can use filtering to filter out billable or non-billable entries and then bulk edit them. If you're not using the dollars as a currency, you can go to the workspace settings and set your currency here. So for example, you can write EUR, and the euro symbol will be displayed in the time tracker and in reports. Billability of time entries determines the total billable amount and profit, and they're calculated with billable rates. On the other hand, cost rates are always applied in order to calculate labor costs, no matter the type of entry. In order for Clockify to calculate your labor cost and profit, you should first enable it in the workspace settings. Once enabled, you can set cost rates and billable rates. You can do that in multiple ways. On a workspace level, for each member, each project, each task, or each member on a specific project. Everywhere you can set billable rates, you can set cost rates in parallel. But the important thing to remember is that more specific rates override less specific rates. To actually see costs and profit, go to any report and select Show Cost and Show Profit in the dropdown. This means you can compare your profit levels by project, client, user, group, and date to see how your business is doing, and on which activities you should focus more in the future. That would be all for the administrative part of our reports. To learn more about report analysis and sharing, make sure to watch our other YouTube tutorials. Thank you all for watching. Bye-bye.